gets Ross tight here. Pick up some extra blocking. Brooks. In motion. Ball. Fumble. And it looks like a Yellow Jacket might have gotten on it. And they did! It's number 56, Abdul Fall, the junior defensive lineman, coming away with that one. Yellow Jackets able to generate a takeaway there. And that's going to be first and 10 for the Yellow Jackets. Already in Panther territory from the 35. Abdul Fall, it wasn't just a gimme to get on top of that one, but was able to make things happen. Now, I will say, the Magnolia game, from the Yellow Jacket perspective, maybe one of the most frustrating things I've ever had to watch last year. It was just back and forth. Nobody was able to do anything that game. I don't think either team was just super happy with it. So this is a team that has had a really unconventional series against each other. The quarterback, John Watson. Both of the Smiths in the backfield, Dante and Cameron. Watson's going to snap the football, hand it off to Dante Smith. He's going to run between the tackles. He's going to go for a short gain. Looks like he picks up about 3 yards. So, sets up second and 7 now.
Two-yard gain on the last play. Brings up second and 8.
So, they're going to say it was a 2-yard gain. Sets up second and 8. John Watson is going to snap it, hand it off to Dante Smith up the middle once again, moving the pile, and he's going to have plenty. He gets the rest of the 8 yards needed for the first down, and then some. Gain of about 13 on the carry.
12-yard gain, number 10.
So a 12-yard gain for Dante Smith, 15 yards on 2 carries for him. And that gives the Yellow Jackets First down of the night. That is a Bobby Lanaw's first down. Expect the best at Bobby Lanaw's Body Shop. In motion. I don't know really what's happening here. Looks like just a blown play from both sides. But it's going to work in Magnolia's favor. Ball was snapped and just immediately went down.
No gain on the play. Second and 10.
So it's going to keep it at second and 10. Second down and 10 for the Yellow Jackets. Watson's going to back away from the center for a second. Offense getting set here. Second down and 10, Watson. Hands it off to Cameron Smith for his first carry of the night. He's going to barrel ahead for about 8 yards.
Number 21, Cameron Smith.
So 8 yards on the carry for Cameron Smith to start things off. Oh, they're going to say he got the whole 10. That's enough for a first down. That is a Sheriff David West first down, putting your safety first. Yellow Jackets did generate that turnover. That was a Ford Dooley and Griffin defensive stop. That's another Yellow Jacket defensive stop. When you need a good defensive team, give the guys at Ford Dooley and Griffin a call at 238-2348. So it's first down and goal for the Yellow Jackets. John Watson hands it off to Dante Smith. His flag out. Probably going to be a false start here.
Flag on the play.
Yeah, Yellow Jackets looking like they're backing up now. And that is going to be a false start. Actually, also is encroachment. So defensive line jumped across, made contact with the Yellow Jacket. So that's going to get us even closer here.
First and goal.
It's going to bring us to about the 4-yard line.
First and goal from the 4-yard line of the Panthers.
Coming to the ball game for the Yellow Jackets, number 3, Siler Holbrook. So they're going to bring out a wide out for the first time tonight. It's going to move the tight end to the other side. It's Cooper Thompson. Motion across from left to right. Watson hands off to Dante Smith. Dante Smith He's just going to fight his way forward. He's going to get forward, but not into the end zone. About 3 yards on the carry. So about 18 yards for him so far. And it's going to get about as close as you can get to the end zone. Yeah, about as close as you can get without getting the touchdown. So, second down and goal. Yellow Jackets going to move this thing forward, and they're into the end zone. So, Yellow Jackets taking the lead over the Magnolia Panthers. And that's going to be a consolidated grain and barge touchdown, proudly serving the agriculture and transportation industries since 1969. It was the quarterback, John Watson, carrying that one himself into the end zone. And that's going to be all we needed for those 6 points. 6:05 left to play in the first quarter. Braden Maddox out to attempt the extra point. And the Magnolia Panther is going to jump off sides there. It's number two, J2 Young. They're going to come around the edge. And it's going to get us just a little bit closer to the goal line. So it looks like we're probably going to go for two here.
Encroachment. Defense. Penalties. Half distance to the goal.
And so that cuts the distance in half to convert. So we're going to go for two here. You never know if that might make the difference in the ball game later on. So it's John Watson, two tight ends for the Yellow Jackets. And the snap. He's going to hand off to Dante Smith. Dante Smith runs between the right tackle and the tight end. And they're going to be stopped short.
2-point conversion, no good.
So, got to give him credit for trying. But that's going to make the score 6-0 with 6:05 left to play in the first quarter. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are here for the first quarter of this non-conference matchup between 5A teams. Yellow Jackets up 6-0 after an unsuccessful two-point attempt on the Wynne Yellow Jackets. Braden Maddox out there to kick this one away once again. Tried to capitalize on the encroachment penalty from the defense of the Panthers. But it did not work out for the Yellow Jackets. Braden Maddox is going to whiff on one. Not sure if that was an onside attempt or not, but it's not going to get 10 yards. I'm really not sure what happened there. Looks like he tried to go for an onside kick, but it just didn't have any juice on it.
Kickoff is down on the Yellow Jacket 47.
So they're going to start this drive off already in.
Correction, on the Yellow Jacket 48.
Already in Yellow Jacket territory. The 48-yard line is where they're going to set up shop. So, Antonio Brooks in motion, Mac Long, and he's going to be brought down to the backfield. It's number 10, Dante Smith. A big loss on the play. 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage for Matt Cross.
Number 10, Cross on the carry.
So a big tackle for loss there on first down. You really need it after giving them such great field position to start off this drive.
Second down and 17.
And this Magnolia offense is struggling here. In motion, Matt Cross. Antonio Brooks hands it off the middle to J2 Young. He's going to get short yardage on the play, maybe three. So that is going to get 3 yards on the carry. That's going to make it third down and 14. So J2 Young, 8 yards on 3 carries. So from the Panther 48-yard line, two wideouts for the Panthers. It's Jaquavius Ross and Nico Gwynn. Brooks trying to throw here, and it's going to fall incomplete. No shot of making that one happen. Well underthrown. Pass was intended for number 10, Matt Cross. That was Antonio Brooks' first pass attempt of the day, and it is not going to go down well for him. So the Panthers 0 for 2 on third down so far. That's another Yellow Jacket defensive stop. When you need a good defensive team, give the guys at Ford, Dooley, and Griffin a call at 238-2348. So fourth down and 14, and they're going to punt this one away. Actually fumbled on the snap. And so that's going to be a turnover on downs.
Snap infraction. Kicking team on the center. 5-yard penalty. Oh. Fourth down.
Actually, so it was a snapping infraction on the kicking team. Not sure if y'all heard that one. So it's just actually going to back them up 5 yards. And they're going to get a punt again. So, they were facing the same confusion we were. Defense already was out on the field for Magnolia, but they're going to send the punt team out there once again. And so there we go. Long snap up in the air. And it is the punter, Braden Sanchez, punting this one away. It's a short punt from the 35-yard line. He's going to switch it around to the 35 on the other side. So 30 yards on the punt from Sanchez. And that's going to have the Yellow Jackets setting up shop with a fresh set of downs on the Yellow Jacket 35. So first down and 10 here for the Yellow Jackets. Watson takes a snap, hands it off to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith making some headway up the middle, but not just too much. Sorry, that was Dante Smith. He's going to pick up 3 yards on the carry.
Second down, 7.
So that's a tough second down and 7.
Second and 7 for the Yellow Jackets from the Yellow Jacket 38.
So second down and 7. Yellow Jackets huddling up here. Drake Harris, the wideout. Braden Maddox in the slot. Cooper Thompson and Braden Maddox in motion. John Watson takes the snap, hands it off to Dante Smith once again up the middle. Able to pick up about 2 between the tackles, and that's going to set up 3rd down and 5.
Game 3, 3rd and 4.
So 3rd down and 4 for the Yellow Jackets. It's the first time they've been faced with 3rd down tonight.
3rd and 4 for Wynne from the Wynne 41.
Bringing in another receiver here. It's Siler Holbrook. So Cooper Thompson, the tight end, lined up on the left side. Siler Holbrook in the right slot. Watson takes a handoff, gives it to Dante Smith. He's got a hole. He's got plenty of space. He's making it across into Panther territory all the way to the 40, 35. There is a flag.
Dante Smith on the carry, flag on the play.
back in the middle of the play. This one may be coming back. Could see a hold here. So a great gain from Dante Smith. Yeah, he got it around about 26 yards. But that is going to come back due to the hold. And you hate to see that. So a 15-yard penalty. Didn't hear what it was, but I think that's going to be... must have been a chop block there if it was two of them. So 15 yards there on the infraction. And that's going to set them up with 3rd and 20, maybe 3rd and 19. So a pretty tall task here. And John Watson rolls out to pass right. Pass is complete to Cooper Thompson. Cooper Thompson is going to get the first down. 21-yard reception for Cooper Thompson. And that's enough for a Yellow Jacket first down. That is a Darlene Andrews Bookkeeping and Tax Service first down. Bookkeeping and Tax Service always in balance, accurate, and always on time. So that's moving the chains for the Yellow Jackets. They're now on their own. Looks like they're on their own 47. 47. A massive passing play from John Watson. And way to move with the ball after the catch to Cooper Thompson. John Watson running this one for himself. Takes it outside, about 6 yards on the carry. Yeah, picks up about, actually, let's say a gain of 7.
Gain of 7. Second down and 3.
So second down and 3 now for the Yellow Jackets. Offense looked pretty good here so far. So 1 minute, 32 seconds left in the first quarter. Jackets up 6-0. Thompson, Maddox on the right side. Watson takes a snap, hands it off to Dante Smith. Dante Smith spins off one tackle, takes it outside to the right. Brings it across the chains. And that's going to be enough for a Yellow Jacket first down. That's a Bull Chevrolet Buick GMC first down. Find new roads. So now on the Magnolia Panthers 42-yard line.
First and 10 for the Yellow Jackets from the Panther 42.
32 yards so far on 6 carries from Dante Smith. So first down and 10 here. Watson hands off to Cameron Smith up the middle. Smith between the tackles. Gain of about 3.
Gain of 2, second and 8.
So 2 yards on the carry
second
from Cameron Smith.
From the Panther 40.
And that's going to be second down and 8 from the Panther 40. Yellow Jackets moving the ball well. Four first downs for them so far. Second down and 8 for the Jackets. Watson hands off to Cameron Smith once again. Cameron Smith maybe another 2 yards on the carry.
Cameron Smith on the carry.
Probably gain of 1 and quarter's going to expire.
Gain of 1. That is the end of the first quarter. Score stands.
So at the end of the first quarter, Yellow Jackets lead the Magnolia Panthers 6-0. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And we are back here from Yellow Jacket Stadium as the Yellow Jackets are leading the 5A South Magnolia Panthers 6-0 here as we begin the second quarter. Yellow Jackets are on offense, moving the other way now. They're got a third down and seven situation. Don't be surprised if they turn to the air. John Watson, 1-for-1, 21 yards so far. Out split wide right, Braden Maddox. They move Dante up the line of scrimmage. He's going to take the snap, hand it off to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith working towards the chains. He's going to get a gain of about 4. And that's going to set up about 4th down and 4.
21, Cameron Smith on the carry.
So Cameron Smith, he's got 18 yards on 4 carries so far tonight.
4th and 4 for the Yellow Jackets.
Yellow Jacket offense still on the field now. Yellow Jackets going to go for it on 4th down here. And looks like they're going to blow that dead right before the snap came out. And that's going to be a timeout charge to Wynne. That's the first timeout of the first half. And it's going to be called at 11:12. It is a Kernodal Funeral Home timeout, your hometown funeral home since 1927. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are. Jacket set to go for it here on 4th down. John Watson, this is unusual, lined up out of the shotgun here. Dante Smith pushed up towards the line of scrimmage. Cam Smith lined up to Watson's right. Braden Maddox split out wide right. Shotgun snap to Watson. Watson rolling out of the pocket right. He's running it for himself. He's got the first down. He's going to be pulled down by his jersey past the first down line. He's going to have a gain of 9 on the carry.
John Watson on the carry, gain of 9 for the Yellow Jackets.
So, 17 yards on 4 carries from John Watson. That's more like it. So, that's going to keep the drive alive for the Yellow Jackets. It's their first and only time facing 4th down tonight, and they were able to convert.
Flag was waved off.
There was a flag down, but the officials are going to call that off.
First and 10, Yellow Jackets.
So first and 10 for the Yellow Jackets. Back to the normal formation. Both the Smiths in the backfield. Watson takes a snap under center. Hands it off to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith has a hole. Runs it up the middle. And he's going to pick up good yardage there.
21, Cameron Smith.
Approaching 10 yards. And they're going to give it to him. 10 yards on the carry. Good enough for a Yellow Jacket first down. That is a more air conditioning first down. Why settle for less when you can have more?
The ball is on the Panther 19.
So on the 19-yard line in Panther territory. Yellow Jackets lined up here. In motion, Dante Smith. He's going to hit it off to Cameron Smith up the middle. Smith moving the pile now. And a gain of about 4.
Gain of 4.
So both Cameron and Dante Smith have 32 yards on 6 carries.
Second down and 6.
Second down and six for the Yellow Jackets. .9:41 left to play in the half. Second down and six for the Yellow Jackets on the Panther 15. And John Watson under center, hands off to Cameron Smith once again. And another maybe 2 yards.
Is good enough to make him the leading rusher so far on the night. 34 yards, 7 carries.
Gain of 2, 3rd and 4.
9:06 running clock for the Yellow Jackets in the red zone here. One for one in the red zone so far. Hands it off to Dante Smith. Trying to move the pile forward. And I don't think it's going to get anywhere here. They're going to give him a gain of 1. Maybe a long 1. Short 2. And so it is a 4th and short situation for the Yellow Jackets. Offense still on the field. They're going to go for it. So 6-0, 8:15 left in the half. Yellow Jackets going for it on 4th down and 1. Watson hands it off to Cameron Smith. And they're going to say he's 21. Got it.
Cameron Smith on the carry, first and 10.
That is a Cross County Farm Bureau first down. Helping you is what we do best. That's going to move the chains. Yellow Jackets 2 for 2. As they're going to be 2 for 2 on 4th downs. So 6-0, still the score. But Yellow Jackets on the Panther 9. John Watson takes a snap, keeps it for himself, dances around the left tackle, slowly moving this offense forward. Maybe 4 yards. So about 4 yards on that one. 5, actually. It's going to set him up on the 4-yard line.
Gain of 5. Second and goal from the 4.
So Yellow Jackets trying to score here from the 4-yard line. Second down. It's a 2 tight end set for the Yellow Jackets. Simars, Cooper Thompson, both out there. Watson snaps, hands off to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith up the middle, and he's in. That's going to be a Yellow Jacket touchdown. That's a consolidated grain and barge touchdown, proudly serving the agricultural and transportation industries since 1969. Cameron Smith in there with the 4-yard rushing touchdown. That's going to put the Yellow Jackets up 12-0. They're going to go for it here, try to even out the score line. Never mind, no, they're not. PA team out there, sorry. Siler Holbrook out there to hold. Saw that number 3, used to seeing him at receiver. And flag is out. The Panther defense is going to jump off sides once again. Question is, are the Yellow Jackets going to stick with their philosophy from the first series? And yes, they are. They're sending the offense out there half the distance of the goal. So Yellow Jackets going to go for 2 once again. So I wasn't wrong. I just was predicting the future. So 6 minutes, 43 seconds. Was the time of the score. Watson pitches it out to Dante Smith. Dante Smith takes it outside. He's in the end zone for the 2-point conversion. That one's good.
10,
Dante Smith wasn't able to convert the first one, but he is able to carry it into the end zone to make the score 14-0. There is 6:43 left in the half. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. We'll be right back. And back we are here. 6:43 left in the first half. It's the second quarter. Jackets up by two scores. They've tied the rest of their season scoring in just one game now. The kickoff is up from Braden Maddox. Back to the deep right side of the end zone. It's number two, J2 Young, bringing this one out. He's got good blocking, able to carry it up to about the 40. So from the Panther 40, that's where Magnolia is going to start out this offensive drive. Jackets able to generate defensive stops on both of their offensive drives so far.
Braylon McDaniel.
It was Braylon McDowell in on the stop there. First down and 10 for the Magnolia Panther offense, set up on their own 40. Antonio Brooks hands it off to J2 Young. And he's going to try to fight forward, but just not going to get anywhere. Correction, that was number 5, Amari Roach. And Roach, so you didn't get anything on that. So no rushing yards for him on one carry. Brooks, the snap under center. He's going to try to keep it for himself. Actually hands it off to Matt Cross. Matt Cross takes it around the outside. And he's able to pick up a gain of about 4. Could have been a whole lot more, but a great open field tackle there. Tackle was made by,
That was 21, number Cameron Smith.
Cameron Smith coming in there from the linebacker position to make the stop.
Cross on the carry. Stopped on the play by Tyler Holbrook.
So third down and 6. In motion, Dismuke. Cross, or Brooks keeps this one for himself. He fumbles! And the Yellow Jackets are going to fall on it. It's number 44, Silas Mars. That's the second takeaway the Yellow Jackets have generated tonight. Si Mars coming up with this one. This Panthers offense not happy. Yellow Jackets up 2 scores and the opportunity to dig this hole a little deeper. That was a 4 Dooley and Griffin defensive stop. That's another Yellow Jacket defensive stop. When you need a good defensive team, give the guys at 4 Dooley and Griffin a call at 238-2348. So first and 10 for the Yellow Jackets on the 50-yard line. The LED lights on the home side flashing the blue and gold. First down and 10. Watson hands off to Cam Smith. Smith up the middle. He's got a hole. 5 yards right up the middle.
21, Cameron Smith on the carry. Gain of 5. Second and
21, can you
second
do some for me?
From the 45.
Second down and 5 for the Yellow Jackets. And they're going to try to keep this train rolling. Magnolia Panthers, despite the long drive, traveled pretty well. Better than you would expect. Such a long road trip. Second down and 5, Yellow Jackets. Up 2 scores, 4:35 left in the half. Sean Watson takes a snap, hands it off to Dante Smith. Dante Smith up the middle. About just a yard on the carry.
Number 10, Dante Smith, gain of 1. Third and 4.
Looks like there is going to be an injured player on the Panthers side. For the Panthers, we're going to take a short break here, and then we'll be back in just a moment to keep this going. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KBYN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are. John Watson keeps this one for himself. Able to fight forward for maybe a yard. It's going to set up fourth down. Fourth down and two. That was number 11, Kevin Carter. He was the Magnolia Panther that was shaken up on the previous play. Now he was able to get up and carry or walk off the field. Without any help. So that's always good to see. Fourth down and two for the Yellow Jacket offense. Going for it for the third time. Driving forward. It's going to be Cam Smith at the bottom of the pile there. And they're going to say he got it.
Cameron Smith on the carry. First down, Yellow Jacket.
And so that's a Yellow Jacket first down. That is a Strickland Plumbing first down, serving all of Wynne and Cross County. So seven first downs for the Yellow Jackets tonight. This is a night and day difference from what we've seen previously in this team. First down at 10, 40-yard line in Panther territory. Watson keeping this one. Dances around the linebackers. And a gain of about five for Watson. So 28 rushing yards for John Watson. Seven carries for him so far. Second down and five. Jackets up 14-0. 2:24 left in the half. Threatening to score once again. Watson keeps it for himself. Dancing forward. Cuts back towards the middle. About 2 yards.
John Watson on the carry, number 12.
Give him three.
Gain of three. Third down and two.
Third down and two for the Yellow Jackets. Jackets are 3-for-3 on fourth down. So far, 2-for-5 on third. Jackets handed off to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith, he's got room to run outside. He got the two, able to stretch it out for a few more.
Number 21, Cameron Smith on the carry.
That was Cameron Smith. And so, about 7 yards on the carry for Cameron Smith. That was enough for a Will Kill pass control first down. Call the hitman at Will Kill. 52 rushing yards for Cam Smith. First down and 10 for the Yellow Jackets. On the 25-yard line of the Panthers, John Watson to pass. He's got it to Braden Maddox. Braden Maddox, the first down and then some. Cutting towards the end zone, just short. They're going to bring him out of bounds at around the 2. They're going to say he was out of bounds at the 1 yard line, a 23-yard pass.
John Watson passing complete to Braden Maddox for 23 yards and a first and goal.
So that's a Bobby Lanaw's first down. Expect the best at Lanaw's Body Shop. So with a minute and 10 seconds to go, Yellow Jackets up by two scores, trying to make it three. Watson. He's going to keep this one himself. Dante Smith's got his hands in the air. And looks like the Yellow Jackets are in there once again. John Watson, his second rushing touchdown of the night. That is a consolidated grain and barge touchdown, proudly serving the agriculture and transportation industries since 1969. So Yellow Jackets now up 20-0 over their 5A opponent in the Magnolia Panthers. PAT team out there for the Yellow Jackets. Officials having some kind of meeting out there. Going over to tell the Wynne coaching staff what's going on. I'm sure we'll be filled into the situation in just a second. So yeah, they informed Coach Toddy about the situation now. Now they're heading over to the Magnolia sideline to talk to Coach Mark King. That's probably something to have to do with, you know, sportsmanship on the field. Just giving a fair warning to both sides to kind of keep tabs on that.
After the play was over, dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct on the defense, number seven. Number seven has been ejected from the game.
So number seven, Lemuel Martin, the senior defensive back for the Panthers, had unsportsmanlike conduct after the play. He's been ejected from the game.
Correction. Seven on
win. Oh, seven on win. So
that'll be Christian Wren.
That is Christian Wren, who's been removed from the ball game. So the official said the wrong team, but no, that's Wynn's Christian Wren. Now the kick is up and good from Braden Maddox.
Kick is good.
Able to convert all three of his extra points so far this year.
Score stands, Wynne 21.
So with 1:04 left in the half, the Yellow Jackets are up 21-0. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are. 1:04 left in the first half. Jackets up big, three scores. Got to keep their foot on the gas. They lost Christian Wren. He got ejected from the ball game.
Number four, Maddox kicking off.
So Braden Maddox is going to be kicking this one off from the 25-yard line. And so Braden Maddox got a tall task ahead of him to boot this one away. Maybe he's feeling good after that PAT. And he's going to pretty much put all he's got into this one. It's going to take a couple hops and bounce out of bounds at around the, you know, 22-yard line. So that'll get them started. That should get them started at the 25-yard line. Kick out of bounds there for Maddox.
Maddox kick off out of bounds.
Free kick out of bounds. Number four on the kicking team. Penalty 5 yards, and we will re-kick.
Oh, so they're going to elect to have Wynne re-kick. Probably a smart move on the Panthers' side. Wynne would be totally happy with having them start off this drive at the 25. We're able to let it hop and get it to roll out of bounds to the point of it being a penalty. But, you know, if it goes out of bounds before the 25-yard line, that would really have to start. But was able to bounce past. So it looks like they're going to elect to make Wynne re-kick and hopefully try to start with a shorter field. So, Braden Maddox. A long run up here for him. And try to put everything he's got into this football. And the boot is up. Looks like they're just going to squib this one. It's going to take a hop. Number one fumbled it, but then he's able to fall back on it. Chavis Johnson.
Kickoff is recovered by number one, Clevis Johnson. First and 10 for the Panthers from the Panther 46.
So, Chavis Johnson. So, Chavis Johnson was able to fall on that one after a little bit of drama. But nonetheless, the Magnolia Panthers offense is going to get things started here at the 44. Antonio Brooks dropping back to pass. Looking to keep this one himself. He's going to be brought down. Cameron Smith in for the sack. Trying to scramble out of the pocket. Extend the play. But that's not going to work out for him.
Caught in the backfield.
And so it's going to be a loss of four there. Antonio Brooks so far on carrying the football, lost a yard, fumbled, and then lost four. In motion, Matt Cross. They're going to pitch it to Matt Cross outside. Cross trying to get north and south, and he will, but he's only going to pick up about three. Well, he able to get back the distance they lost. So that is going to set up third down and nine. Flag is coming out late. Most likely unsportsmanlike, number 19 on the Panthers, hands in the air, Jaquavius Ross, the senior wide receiver. So he's the one that seemed to be offended at the call. So let's see how the officiating crew handles this. So third down and nine. And yep.
The play was over. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Get the offense, number 10.
So it's actually
has been disqualified from the contest. The penalty is 15 yards, third down.
So it was number 10, Matt Cross, and he's been ejected from the game. 15 yards was the penalty, third and long.
Third and 25.
So that should be, 15 yards in ejection. That should be anything with contact, fighting, hitting a referee. So time's going to expire there at the – that's going to be the end of the half. I'm sorry I haven't been mentioning the time more. It's an interesting situation. If we get an update on that, I will let you know at the as soon as possible. But at the half, the Yellow Jackets – are up 21-0. We'll be right back for the Pitchford Ag Halftime Show. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWYN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are here for the Pitchford Ag Halftime Show. Take a second to recognize the Moore Air Conditioning Offensive Lineman of the Week. Moore Air Conditioning is proud to present the Offensive Lineman of the Week. That's right. Moore is rewarding the guys in the trenches all year long across Northeast Arkansas. And this week's winner is Evan Schrout of Truman, the Moore Air Conditioning Offensive Lineman of the Week. Now we're going to send it over to Jason Stallings, the producer over at the station, who's going to go about some regional matchups and just give you all some insight into how Friday nights are looking all around the state. Over to you, Jason.
proudly supports the DIYer in you. Whether you're a mover, a shaker, a groundbreaker, a risk taker, a challenge embracer, or a landscape visionary, whatever the task, we've got a John Deere tractor that can help move your project forward. You've got work to do, so let's get started. Reserve yours today in store or at gogreenway.com.
When you walk into our store, you know you're going to be taken care of. You know that we know you. We treat you just like you're part of our family.
We let our customers know that we appreciate them.
We want to make them feel like families when they come into our stores.
I think a customer should expect from every Jordan's to be clean, friendly, and a family atmosphere. If they can stop anywhere and get gas, we want them to stop at Jordan's.
And back we are here for the Pitchford Ag Halftime Show. We're going to talk a little about some of Wynne's other sports. Highlight all the Yellow Jackets here on KWIN. Avery, let's start off with tennis. How'd they do?
Okay, so yesterday tennis had a match. Okay, so we'll talk about stats from there. So the boys singles had 2 wins and 0 losses. Boys doubles had 1 win and 1 loss. Girls singles had 2 wins and 1 loss. The girls doubles had 3 wins and 0 losses. And the players of those games were Kate Cathy, Hugh Owens, and Katie Moore.
Yeah, Yellow Jackets. They had a good showing there against the, I think it was Harrisburg, right?
Yes.
Harrisburg. And then let's talk about the, they've been naming athletes, scholars of the week. Who have those been for the Yellow Jackets?
Yes, okay. So this week, athlete of the week would be Garrett Peavy, and scholar of the week would be Reese Roberts.
And then how about that volleyball team? They have been doing pretty well. Let's hear about how they've been doing.
Okay, so Tuesday we played the Jonesboro Hurricanes. We won 25-27, 25-20, and 25-19. The player of that game will be Callan Smith with 8 out of 8 hitting, 2 kills, 13 out of 13 serves, 4 aces, and 3 digs. Thursday we played the Truman Wildcats. We won 25-8, 25-12, and 25-9. The player of that game will be Shea Walton with 30 assists, 4 kills, 4 digs, and 3 aces.
Wow, with consistency like that, it's really hard not to have success. Seems like Yellow Jackets have been doing pretty well all around the board because we all know they don't just survive, they thrive. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back to go over some game stats for the Pitchford Ag Halftime Show. Yellow Jackets are leading 21-0. 6 minutes left in halftime. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are for the Pitchford Ag Halftime Show. We're going to go over some offensive stats. There's about 3 minutes until, well, it should be 3 minutes until the second half kickoff, but usually they will add some additional time there for both teams to warm up. So let's start off with offense, and we'll start with lack thereof offense for the Magnolia Panthers. So they have generated 27 offensive yards throughout the first half. Their quarterback, Antonio Brooks, -5 rushing yards, 0 for 1 passing, 2 fumbles. J2 Young, the fullback, 8 yards on 3 carries. Number 10, Matt Cross, he had 2 carries for -9 yards. He had -2 yards. And he was actually ejected from the game during the first half. Number 3, Dakota Dismuke, actually one of 2 Magnolia Panthers with positive yardage. He's got 25 yards on just 1 carry. And Amari Roach, number 5, who has carried the football 1 time and made it just back to the line of scrimmage.
On third downs, they are 0 for 6. One of them being a fumble. And Braden Sanchez has punted the football one time for 30 yards. So, team as a whole, 27 yards of offense. Yellow Jackets, different story. Usually these two teams, if you look at last week, Wynne would be the team with 27 yards total. But could not be further from the truth. Wynne offense, 163 yards total, 119 rushing yards, 44 passing yards. They just turned the lights off on me, so I'm pulling out my flashlight. John Watson, 2 for 2, 44 yards passing. Braden Maddox hauled in one of those receptions for 23 yards. Cooper Thompson hauled in the other one for 21 yards. The tight end actually caught it after about 10, carried it the other 11. Dante Smith, 35 yards, 8 carries, 4.3 yards a carry. Cameron Smith, 52 yards on 11 carries, 4.7 yards a carry for Cameron Smith. And John Watson back in action carrying the football. Good to see that. 32 yards. 32 yards on 9 carry. 3.5 yards a carry. 2 scores for John Watson. Both of them 1 yard rushing touchdowns. I meant also need to mention Cameron Smith had a 4 yard rushing touchdown. Dante Smith had a 2-point conversion. So tack that on there. Jackets 3 for 3 in the red zone. They have accrued 7 first downs. They are actually 1 for 5 on third downs, but able to make something happen because they have went for it 3 times on fourth down and gotten it all 3 times. Haven't had to punt once. Braden Maddox, 3 for 3, or sorry, is just 1 for 1 on PATs, 3 for 3 on the season. And we have only used 1 timeout that half. So, we're going to keep it right here, and we're going to send it to Avery over there to go over the defensive stats, starting out with the Magnolia Panthers.
Okay, so number 21, Leighton Daniels has 4 tackles. Amarion Harris has 3. Kevin Carter has 3. Varen Tucker has 2. Braden Parkway has 4. Chevis Johnson has 2. Lamel Martin has 1. Condarius Walter has 1. And Dakota Dismute has 2. Now we're going to go into the Yellow Jackets. And Ron, I'm going to start off with the 2 most important, which are the fumble recoveries made by number 56 and number 44, Abdul Sfall and Cy Mars. So, now we're going to get into tackles. We have number 7, Christian Wren, has 1. Number 21, Cam Smith, has 3. Number 20, Mason Stallings, has 2. Number 44, Cy Mars, has 1. Abdul Fall, number 56, has 1. Dante Smith, number 10, with 1. Number 60, James Archer, with 2. Number 5, James Jarrett, with 1. 55, Tyler Rowland, with 1. And number 17, Drake Harris, with 1 as well.
And so that about wraps things up on the Pitchford Ag Halftime Show. We're going to take a second to thank all the sponsors here. Westmoreland Heating and Air, First Financial Bank, Lexicon, State Farm, Meredith Peeler, Heartland Chrysler Dodge, Jeep Ram, Hayes Foodtown, Two Sisters Family Medicals, Senator Ronald Caldwell, Shelter Insurance, Tyler Waymire, Harmony Health Clinic, Hess Shoes, Taylor Arms, Witcher Auction, Miller & Sullivan Accounting, Wynn Apothecary, Southern Furniture, Greenway Equipment, The Sign Shop, Red River Ford Toyota, AR Ship, Ungerank Chiropractic, Caldwell Lumber, ECS House Industries, Evolve Bank, Representative Steve Hollowell, Caldwell Pharmacy, County Line Irrigation, Pico Foods, Lawson Insurance, and First National Bank of Eastern Arkansas. Those sponsors make the broadcast possible. Now, as we move towards the second half, I'd like to present the second half sponsor. The kickoff is brought to you by Primary Residential Mortgage. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. We'll be back for the second half right after this.
Braden Sanchez with the kickoff of the second half, brought to you by Primary Residential Mortgage. Took a hop at about the 5-yard line. Braylon McDowell seemed to think that was going to make it to the end zone for a touchback, but it took a hop. So Braylon scooped it up, tried to move it forward. Flag on the play. It's going to be holding on the Yellow Jackets. And so that's going to set the Yellow Jackets up at their own 5-yard line. 95 yards to go with this first and 10. Watson under center. Hands it off to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith moves towards the left, cuts back inside. Short gain for him. Just a little bit of breathing room. And about 4 yards on the carry.
Gaining 4 yards, second down and six.
Avery, tell us a little bit about this student section theme this week.
So this week's student section theme was construction, and I think our students took that pretty well. It's pretty neon, pretty bright over there. The stands are packed, Ron. You know, vibes are good. Everybody's excited that the Yellow Jackets have finally put some points on the board.
John Watson keeping this one for himself. Dancing outside. Brings it around the tackles. Picks up a couple more on the play. Tackled inbounds. About 3 yards on the carry from John Watson. 37 rushing yards for him.
Third down and two.
So sets up third down and two. Yeah, the construction theme really does illustrate the hardworking mentality of this football team.
Third and two for the Yellow Jackets from the Yellow Jacket 13.
So third down and two. Jackets 1-for-4 on third down tonight. Offense been kept alive by some success going for it on fourth. And Cameron Smith able to make things happen, moving the chains. A gain of about 6.
21, Cameron Smith on the carry.
So he's got 62 rushing yards. That is a Sheriff David West first down, putting your safety first.
Gain of 9.
9 yards on the carry.
First and 10, Yellow Jackets from the Yellow Jacket, 22.
Cameron Smith, the rushing leader for the Jackets, 65 yards. First down at 10 from the 24. I think it was Watson keeping it himself this time. And didn't lose any there. Maybe a gain of 1.
Gain of 1, second and 9.
So second down and 9 for the Yellow Jackets. 9:34 left to play in the third quarter. And about the entire Magnolia defense jumped off sides there. So it's going to be called on number 35 on the Magnolia Panthers. That's going to be Condarius Waller, the senior defensive lineman.
Second and 4 for the Yellow Jackets from the 29-yard line of
Wynne. So second down and 4. Jackets able to really turn things around from being backed up in their own end zone. Second and 4, Watson hands it off to Cam Smith. No, Dante. Actually, it looks like he pulled that one back, kept it for himself. That's the...
No gain on the play.
John Watson we know and love, but
and
didn't get anything there. Coming into the ball game for the Yellow Jackets, Anthony Smith, the tight end. Cooper Thompson still in there in the huddle. Wynne trying to load the line of scrimmage here. Thompson, Smith. Dante Smith motions behind Watson. Watson keeps it for himself, driving forward, and he's going to be stopped short. So Jackets still struggling on third down. And about a gain of 2 there from John Watson. That puts him at the 40-yard mark for a 4th-and-1 situation. Jacket offense staying on the field. Yet to punt it tonight.
3 for 3 on first downs. Yeah, fourth down and one. And John Watson. He's going to keep this one for himself. Quarterback sneak up the middle. And both teams seem to think that their side is right. Wynne thinks they got it. And Wynne would be correct. John Watson, 1 yard gain there. That's going to be a first down. It's a Darlene Andrews first down. Bookkeeping and tax service, always in balance, accurate, and always on time. So 4 for 4 on fourth downs, the Yellow Jackets. First down and 10. Cameron and Dante Smith in the backfield. Watson on the draw play. Hands it off to... That's Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith up the middle for 6 yards.
Cameron Smith. Gain of 6. Second and 4.
So second down and 4 for the Yellow Jackets. Still on their own 40. Yellow Jacket offense hasn't had too many struggles tonight. Even when they've, you know, had some, faced some fourth down situations, hasn't been too much to them. Dante Smith takes it outside, brings it around to the right. He's going to evade a few tacklers, able to move the chains for the Yellow Jackets once again.
Gain of 6.
Gain of 6 there for Dante Smith. That is a Bull Chevrolet Buick GMC first down. Find new roads. So first down and 10 for the Yellow Jacket offense. Braden Maddox. Lined it split in. Pitch out to Dante Smith. Dante Smith on the wide side of the field. He's got a first down. 11 yards on the outside carry. Dante Smith.
Number 10, Dante Smith on the carry.
That's going to be another Yellow Jacket first down. A Cronodal Funeral Home first down. Your hometown funeral home since 1927.
First and 10 for Wynne from the Magnolia 43.
So first down and 10 for the Yellow Jackets once again. They have just been rolling down the field after starting out really poor field position. Watson hands this one off to Cameron Smith.
21, Cameron Smith on the carry.
Maybe a long 1 yard gain.
Gain of 1, second and 9.
Avery, it has just been perfect weather for football. We've been really lucky this season. No rain. No crazy wind. What's the weather like tonight here at Yellow Jacket Stadium?
Absolutely, Ron. So it's 70 degrees outside. You know, it's mostly clear. There's nothing in the sky. You know, it's definitely what you want to see on nights like this. The high today was actually 83, so definitely one of the better weathers we had.
John Watson keeps this one outside. Cuts in. Moves it around back out to the right. Watson able to get this one out of the box and move the chains once again. Do have an injured Panther on the field. About a 15-yard gain. 17 yards. Sorry, 17 yards on the gain for John Watson. A first down, a more air conditioning first down. Why settle for less when you can have more? 4:43 left in the third quarter. Jackets just moving along smoothly. Up 21-0.
First and 10, Yellow Jackets, from the 25-yard line of the Panthers.
So, on the 25-yard line in Panther territory, Yellow Jackets gonna push forward, try to make this a four-score ball game. Watson hands it off to Dante Smith. Cam Smith.
Cameron Smith, 21.
And just another consistent gain from Cam Smith. 4, maybe 3 yards on the carry.
Gain of 3. Second down, 7.
Consistency kills, and that has really just been the tale tonight.
Second and 7 from the 20.
Cameron Smith has just chipped away at this Magnolia defense. Will Watson in for the Yellow Jackets at that right halfback position. Watson looks like a bad snap. Going to try to keep it for himself, minimize the damage. Leap forward. Late flag there.
Watson on left carry. Flag on play.
There is a flag. Flag came in late. Officials at the center of the huddle trying to talk this one out. Wynne backing up here.
After the play was over, personal foul on the offense, number 60. That penalty is 15 yards from the end of the run. The play count, third down.
And so that's going to be a personal foul on the Yellow Jackets. Didn't say what it was. But that's going to be third down and, let's see, third down and about 22. 21 yards. So Watson pitches it out to Dante Smith. Dante Smith able to make some significant headway. At least 10 yards on the carry. Maybe 13, upwards of 14.
Dante Smith on the carry, number 10. Gain of 15.
They're going to give him 15. And so there is an injured Panther on the field. Training staff is out there. We're going to take a short break. Yellow Jackets up over the Magnolia Panthers, 21-0. 3:16 left in the third quarter. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are. 3:16 left in the third quarter. The injured Panther looks like it might be, could be number 1. Avery, you're the one that can read numbers. I think it is number 1. He's looks like it's something with his arm. He's kind of covering up the number there. I think that's going to be number 1, Javis Johnson, the sophomore linebacker and fullback.
Oh, looky there, you would be right.
That was a lucky guess. But no, he was able to get off. Just a little bit of help from the athletic trainer, but didn't look like to be anything too serious. Fourth down and 7 for the Yellow Jackets. Able to make a pretty big gain there to make it a lot more manageable. Jackets going to go for it. It's worked for him so far. Why not? 4 for 4 so far on fourth downs. John Watson under center. Takes a snap, keeps it for himself. Look at the pass. John Watson. He's going to air it out and gets it to Symars. Symars hauls it in, but it's not going to be enough for the first.
Pass complete, but short of the first.
So, maybe about 3 yards on the reception to Symars. Now, John Watson pretty much has eliminated, I shouldn't say anything, but John Watson pretty much eliminated the turnover problem, 3 for 3, and he's been pretty much on target all night. But despite that, turnover on downs. And that's going to send the Magnolia Panthers out there. Try to chip away at this Wynne lead with 2:53 left in the third. Ball on the 21-yard line. And Antonio Brooks. Brooks. He's going to hand that one off to the fullback, Amari Roach.
Amari Roach up the middle.
Number five, Amari Roach on the carry.
And he's going to get a gain of about four.
Gain of four, second and six.
So just Roach's second carry of the night. 4 yards for him. Second down and five for the Panthers. Antonio Brooks hands it off to Roach once again. Roach dances around in the backfield. Able to pick up one, maybe 2 yards. So a gain of two from Amari Roach makes it six as the total for him so far tonight. Running clock, less than 2 minutes remaining in the third. 21-0 the score. Yellow Jackets leading big for the first time this season. Panthers. Brooks keeps it for himself. Dances outside towards the wide side of the field. Brings around the tackle. Short of the first down. It's going to set up fourth and one.
Brooks on the carry. Fourth and one.
Fourth down and one for the Panthers. They have a tight end lined up. One wide out, number 10. They're going to give it to Amari Roach, and he's got nothing. The Jackets coming up with a fumble. Would have been a turnover on downs regardless, but Yellow Jackets making it happen. Yeah, so that's going to be a turnover on downs. And that's going to be a Ford, Dooley, and Griffin defensive stop. When you need a good defensive team, give the guys at Ford, Dooley, and Griffin a call at 238-2348.
First and
10 for the Yellow Jackets. Now on the Panther 29-yard line. Already deep in territory. First down and 10. Yellow Jackets leading in with the football. 1 minute, 4 seconds. And looks like Wynne probably going to call a timeout here. Yeah. So play clock winding down. And so they're going to call a timeout there. That was their first timeout of the half. Called with 1 minute, 4 seconds. Oh, no. So they are going to bring that flag out. Wynn wasn't able to get the timeout off in time. And so that's going to be a 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down. First down at 15 for the Jackets.
First and 15.
First down at 15. Dante Smith driving forward. Takes this one up the middle. Able to move it forward a little bit.
Number 10, Dante Smith.
About
on the
2 yards. 2 yards from Dante Smith. 69 rushing yards on 12 carries for in the night.
Second 13.
Second down and 13 for the Jackets. 3 yards from the original line of scrimmage. They started out the drive. Watson. Keeps it for himself. Brings it around outside. Watson's got a little bit of room to run. Tiptoes down the sideline. And is going to be brought out at around the 20. So, yeah, at about the... They're going to say he stayed in way longer. So he's going to... He was able to dance all the way. Yeah, all the way up to the 20. And 12 yards on the carry from John Watson.
Third and one.
So that sets up third down and one for the Yellow Jackets. Third down and one. Watson, quarterback sneak. And he's got it.
Watson on the carry.
No question there. Watson's got it. That is a Cross County Farm Bureau first down. Helping you is what we do best.
There is a flag down. And
personal foul, face mask, defense, number one.
That is a first down on the defense. Chavis Johnson, the sophomore linebacker, being at the 20-yard line.
First and goal.
It's going to be half the distance to the goal. So that's going to move the Yellow Jackets up to the 10-yard line. And as the quarter expires, Yellow Jackets are going to try to pick this up where they left off in the fourth quarter. So at the end of three, Yellow Jackets lead the Magnolia Panthers 21-0. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And so back we are for the final quarter of this non-conference matchup between 5A teams. Yellow Jackets of the 5A East leading the Magnolia Panthers 21-0. Panthers of the 5A South finished fourth in the 5A South last year. Had a first-round playoff elimination against Joe T. Robinson. Robinson really a perennial powerhouse. Had a lot of success in recent years. First and goal for the Yellow Jackets. Watson pitches it out to Cam Smith on the right side. Short the narrow side of the field. Able to get it a little closer there. Maybe gets it down to the 8. So 2 yards on the carry from Cameron Smith. Jackets shared the load really well tonight. 69 yards for Dante Smith, 77 for Cameron Smith, 70 for John Watson. I mean, that is just some serious diversity in the ground game. Second down and goal from the 7-yard line. Watson hands it off to Dante Smith. Dante Smith cuts out right. Back inside, just inching ever closer to that goal line. Maybe give him two more. 71 yards on 13 carries for Dante Smith. Third and goal.
Third and goal from the 6.
From the 6-yard line now. Jackets 1-for-5 on third downs. 4-for-4 on fourth downs. Not a usual stat line, but. And John Watson hands it off to Cameron Smith. Barrels forward. And he's in. Cameron Smith. A 6-yard rushing touchdown for Cameron Smith. He's got 83 rushing yards on 18 carries. That's a consolidated grain and barge touchdown. Proudly serving the agriculture and transportation industries since 1969. So, the Yellow Jackets leading 27-0 over the Magnolia Panthers. Siler Holbrook out there to hold for Braden Maddox. The long snapper, Cy Mars. And the snap from Mars. Low snap. Bad hold there. Flag is out. Late flag. Kick was no good.
Kick was no good.
But we might get another shot. The story's been the same. 2 times for the Panthers. Encroachment on the extra point attempt twice so far. Let's see if that's a third time. Yeah, And so, regardless of the call, Maddox and Holbrook still out there. And so, some kind of delay happening. It's some kind of a discussion between the referee, Brad Davidson, and the umpire, Tony Davis. Oh, so it's hurdling. Hurdling on the defense. You don't see that call just too often. Hurdling, that's where they just try to jump over the blocking team. So the kicking team, you know, they have the right to not be jumped over. And that's what they tried to do there. Try to block the kick, just try to leap over the kicking team. So Maddox going to get another shot here. High snap this time. End over end kick, and it's good. Braden Maddox, 2 for 2. Nobody saw that last one. Jackets up 28-0 over the Magnolia Panthers. 10:35 left to play in the ballgame. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are for fourth quarter football. Friday Night Lights here at Yellow Jacket Stadium. Yellow Jackets up 28-0. 10:35 left in the fourth quarter.
Number 15, Cameron Burton, deep for the Panthers.
Burton, deep for the Panthers. Number 15, Camarion Burton. Braden Maddox out to kick it off after the successful extra point. So 10:35, and the kick is up. Going to be back deep. And it's a touchback for Braden Maddox. So far, so good for him tonight. 2 for 2 on PATs, a touchback. And he is happy about that one. I don't know if y'all hear that. There's a Braden Maddox chant. Just curious as to if that was able to get over the air. So first down at 10. For the Magnolia Panthers, still scoreless after three quarters and a little bit more. Two wide outs for the Panthers, O'Gwynn and Ross. They're going to hand it off to Roach. Actually, no, keeps it for himself, tries to dish it to the slot back, Caleb Roach. And they're going to get it back to the line of scrimmage, maybe 1 yard more. Number 4, Caleb Roach.
Number 4, Caleb Roach.
Able to go for about one there.
Stop on the play by number 10, Dante Smith.
Dante Smith in on the stop for the Yellow Jackets there. Second down and 9 from the Magnolia 21. Antonio Brooks rolling out to pass, tries to bring this one out to the left, underthrows his receiver after the big pursuit from Dante Smith. That is quite an imposing figure. I wouldn't want to be chased by Dante Smith either. So third down and 9.
Ball is marked. Third and 9.
So third down and 9. And Antonio Brooks, 0-for-2 passing the football tonight. Third down, Brooks. He's going to get that one to Amari Roach. Amari Roach outside. He's got plenty of room to run. Carries it across midfield all the way to the Yellow Jacket 40 before being brought out of bounds by number 5 on the Yellow Jackets. That's James Jarrett.
Antonio Brooks on the carry.
So Antonio, sorry, Amari Roach on the carry there. A big, big gain. Antonio Brooks hands it off to Roach once again. This time not nearly as successful. No gain on the carry from Amari Roach. They're going to bring J2 Young back into the game at fullback.
Illegal formation. More than four players in the offensive backfield. 5 yard penalty from the previous spot. Second down. Correction. First down.
So they're going to call legal formation on the Panthers once again. So that actually eliminates the
penalty. First and 15.
Play. It's going to set up first down at 15 for
first
the Panthers.
15 from the Wynne, 43.
In motion, number 7, Lemuel Martin. Martin outside. Tries to get north and south. Able to turn the corner around the left tackle. Pick up about 4 on the carry. Makes back some of the lost yardage from the penalty. Sets up about 2nd and 11. It was Lemuel Martin.
2nd and 12.
So 2nd down and 12 for the Panthers. 8:36 left to play. 28-0. Yellow Jackets lead the Panthers. Magnolia. Last year, Jackets fell 7-21 at Panther Stadium in Magnolia. 2nd down and 12. Panther in motion. Antonio Brooks drops back to pass. Steps into the pocket. Hot pursuit from the Yellow Jackets, and they're going to bring him down. In on the sack. Looks like it's number 50. Is that number 50? Number 60 on the Yellow Jackets. I think that sack goes to James Archer.
Loss of 4. Brings up 3rd.
So a loss of 4 from Antonio Brooks. Negative 6 rushing yards for him tonight. 3rd down and 16 for the Patriot, or sorry, for the Panthers. I haven't said that all night. Patriots. It's been 2 weeks. Sorry. 3rd down and 16 for the Panthers. They're going to pitch. Their flag is out. It's Caleb Roach dancing all around the backfield. Just struggles to find any positive yardage out of that. And a flag down. Antonio Brooks seems to know this one's moving the Panthers back.
Caleb Roach on the carry.
Illegal formation. More than 4 offensive players in the backfield on the offense.
So once again, illegal formation on the Panthers.
Game of 5 on the last play.
And so that sets up 4th and 11 after the penalty. Fourth down and 11. Not too many options here. Panthers going to have to go for it here. Fourth down and 11. Antonio Brooks. Brooks, 5-step drop. Looking downfield. Rolls out of the pocket left. Stepping up to the line of scrimmage. And a pass broken up. Braylon McDowell gets a hand on it. Incomplete. That's going to be a turnover on downs. That's another Yellow Jacket defensive stop. A Ford Dooley and Griffin defensive stop. When you need a good defensive team, give the guys at Ford Dooley and Griffin a call at 238-2348.
Yellow Jackets hold and take over on down.
And so the Yellow Jackets going to take over. Looks like they're going to take over at their own 39. Antonio Brooks, 0-for-3 passing the football tonight. John Watson, under center. Hands off to Dante Smith. Dante Smith finds a hole. He's going to barrel forward for a first down, about 12 yards straight up the middle for Dante Smith. 83 rushing yards for Dante Smith. 83 rushing yards for Cameron Smith. While we're at it. Gain of 11 on the carry. And to Panther territory. On the 49-yard line, first down and 10. Avery the way the Yellow Jackets have played has been totally different as it has been previous games so far this season. Hold on, we'll talk about it in just a second. First down and 10 for the Yellow Jackets. Sean Watson. There's the snap. Hands it off to Dante Smith up the middle once again. 6, 7, 8 yards. Just no one can bring him down. It has been just a great game for the Yellow Jackets. You know, how should a Yellow Jacket fan feel watching this game and thinking about those earlier games in the season?
You know, the hope should be high after, you know, watching this and seeing how far we've come playing Magnolia and then versus, you know, us playing Marion and Southside. You know, a Jacket fan should understand that we are thriving right now, Ryan.
I mean, it is a long season ahead, and this gives us something to be hopeful for. Second down and 2. Yellow Jackets trying to move the chains here. Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith's got plenty. Dances inside. Looks like he's tripped by the 35-yard line. And it's going to be good enough for a Strickland Plumbing first down, serving all of Wynne and Cross County. A 9-yard gain from Cameron Smith. 92 rushing yards for him. Jackets. I don't want to say anything, jinx anyone, but with 5:40 left to play in the fourth, Jackets potential to have 200-yard rushers tonight. First down and 10 on the 33-yard line. John Watson in motion. Dante Smith hands it off to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith brought down by multiple Magnolia Panthers there. So no gain on the play there. Cameron Smith, still 92 yards.
Dante Smith on the carry, no gain. Second and 10.
Second down and 10 for the Yellow Jackets. 4:50 left to play. So second down and 10. And there's the snap. Pitch outside to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith dodges one tackle. A juke inside. Cuts back towards the middle of the field, and he's got a gain of about 6.
Cameron Smith on the carry.
So that's going to bring up 3rd down and 4.
Gain of 6 yards, 3rd and 4.
So 3rd down and 4 for the Yellow Jackets now. Siler Holbrook retrieving the play for the Yellow Jackets. Back in the huddle. Holbrook lined up at split end. Dante and Cam Smith in the backfield. Cooper Thompson lined up at tight end. Watson. Watson hands it off to Cameron Smith. Cameron Smith up the middle. Dances inside. Cuts back. 5 yards. 10 yards. A first down and
Cameron
more.
Smith on the carry. First and 10, Yellow Jackets.
That's going to be a will kill pest control. First down. Call the hit bin at will kill. 3 minutes, 47 seconds left to go.
First and 10 for the Yellow Jackets from the Magnolia 12.
12-yard gain there on the carry from Cameron Smith. Brings him across the century mark, 110.
Way down the line.
110 rushing yards for him so far tonight. First and 10 for the Jackets. Cameron Smith. Sorry, that would have been
number 21, Cameron.
Yeah, it was 21, Cameron Smith. On the carry once again.
Gain of 3.
He picked up 3 yards on the carry there. Second down and 7 for the Yellow Jackets on the 9-yard line.
The Yellow Jackets from the 9.
They can get a first down without scoring. Watson. Watson's going to hand it off to Cameron Smith once again. 2:32 left to play in the ball game. That clock's still running. About 2 more yards on the carry from Cameron Smith.
21 Smith on the carry. Gain of 2, 3rd and 5.
So 3rd down and 5. Coach Tani of the Jackets bringing in another tight end, Cy Mars and Cooper Thompson.
So third down and four. They're going to hand it off to Cameron Smith once again. Cameron Smith diving forward. And it does that get him the first down. And that is going to be the first down. So that's going to bring it to about the 2 yard line and give Cam Smith the first down. 120 rushing yards for him tonight. That is a Bobby Lanaw's first down. Expect the best at Lanaw's Body Shop. So first down and goal from the 3 yard line. John Watson hands it off to Dante Smith. Dante Smith is into the end zone for a Yellow Jacket touchdown. So, 34-0 the score. A consolidated grain and barge Yellow Jacket touchdown, proudly serving the agriculture and transportation industries since 1969. 34-0 the score. 1:16 left to play in the ballgame. So it's Braden Maddox out to attempt the extra point. He's 2 for 2 tonight.
Resulting play was a touchdown. After the play was over, personal foul. Defense number 35.
There is a flag on the play. It is a personal foul on number 5. 35. Number 35, Kondarius Waller, the senior defensive lineman and linebacker. So that'll be assessed on the kickoff. 34-0 the score. Braden Maddox out there to try to make it 35. Kick is up, end over end kick, and it's good. Braden Maddox 3 for 3 on PATs tonight. So 35-0 is the score with 1:16 left to play in the ballgame. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWYN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And so, the kickoff from Braden Maddox has the Panthers getting started at their own 20-yard line. Braden Maddox had a great game tonight. First down and 10 for the Panther offense. And they're going to hand it off up the middle to, I think it's number 2. J2 Young. Maybe 3 yards on the carry there from Young. He's got 11 rushing yards on 4 carries. Second down and 7 for the Panthers. Brooks, he's going to swing it outside to Malik Blanks, the sophomore. Blanks tries to turn the corner. Tackle made by number 4, Braden Maddox. That's going to set up third down and 5. Malik Blanks. About 2 yards, 20 seconds. Left to go in the ball game. And that clock is going to keep running down. One more play here probably. Brooks under center. In motion, Roach.
They're going to swing it out to Roach. Roach down the sideline, and he's going to be brought out of bounds at around the 40. That's going to be the ball game. Clock reads zero. And so that's it. Yellow Jackets, 35. Magnolia Panthers, zero. The Yellow Jackets, no longer winless, and against a divisional opponent nonetheless. Stay tuned, as we'll be back in just a bit for the beginning of the Crossridge Community Hospital postgame show, where we'll talk about the Yellow Jacket game, as well as some games from around the region. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. And back we are for the Crossridge Community Hospital postgame show. I'm here for just a second. I'm about to send it over to Jason Stallings at the station to give you some more scoring updates around the region, to just give you a little bit more insight into what Friday nights look like all around Northeast Arkansas. Jason, over to you.
And back we are for the Crossridge Community Hospital postgame show. We're going to go over the offensive and defensive stats for both teams in this big Yellow Jacket victory. Let's start off with the Magnolia Panthers. They had 69 yards of total offense tonight. Their quarterback, Antonio Brooks, finished the game with negative 6 rushing yards, 2 fumbles. The fullback, J2 Young, 11 rushing yards. Matt Cross, he did get ejected in the earlier the ball game, negative 2 rushing yards for him. Dakota Dismuke, 25 yards. Y. Roach, 31 yards. Caleb Roach had 6. Lemuel Martin had 4 rushing yards. Braden Sanchez had 1 punt for 30 yards. Antonio Brooks, 0 for 3 passing. And that is it. So 69 yards of offense, all on the ground for the Panthers. Now let's move on to the Wynne Yellow Jackets. 5 touchdowns, 283 rushing yards, 47 passing yards, 330 yards of total offense for the Wynne Yellow Jackets. Starting off the passing game with John Watson, 3 for 3 with 47 yards. One reception was Braden Maddox for 23 yards. Cooper Thompson hauled one in for 21 yards. And Simars had one for, he worked out for about 5. Dante Smith in the rushing game, 93 yards, a touchdown, 5.8 yards a carry for him, 2-point conversion. He went 1 for 2 on those. 4.7 yards a carry for Cameron Smith. He had 120 rushing yards on 25 carries, 2 touchdowns for him. John Watson, 70 rushing yards on 16 carries, 2 touchdowns, 4.3 yards a carry. Yellow Jackets had went 1 for 5 on third downs, 4 for 4 going for it on fourth downs. Brad Maddox was 3 for 3 on PATs and 2 touchbacks. And so that's about all for the Yellow Jacket offensive statistics. Let's send it over to Avery, who's going to talk about the defensive stats, starting with the Magnolia Panthers.
Okay, so 21 Leighton Davis has 5 tackles. Number 50, Amarion Harris has 6. Number 11, Kevin Carter has 6. Number 66, Vernon Tucker has 2. Number 16, Braden Purifoy has 6. Number 1, Chavis Johnson has 3. Number 7, Lemanuel Martin has 3. Number 35, Quadarius Walter has 2. Number 3, Dakota Dismuke has 2. Number 15, Kamarion Burton has 1. Number 58, Tylee Brutal has 1. Number 79, LD Thomas has 2. Number 2, J2 Young has 2. And then number 9, Walker Carter has 1. I will switch to the Yellow Jackets. Christian Wren ended with 1. That was before, the ejection happened. Number 21, Cameron Smith has 3. Number 20, Mason Stallings has 2. Number 44, Sam Mars has 2 tackles. And let's not forget about his fumble recovery. Number 56, Abdul Fall has 1 tackle, and he also got a fumble recovery tonight. Number 10, Dante Smith has 10. Number 10, Dante Smith. Number 60, James Archer has 3. Number 5, James Jarrett has 2. Number 55, Tyler Rowland has 1. And number 17, Drake Harris also has 1.
So that's the stats for both teams. Yellow Jackets took down the Magnolia Panthers 35-0. This is the Crossridge Community Hospital postgame show. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. When we're back, we're going to interview Coach Toddy and look forward to next week's game and reflect a little bit about this victory. We'll be right back. Should be 3. Let me check. Yep. All right, Coach. I guess we'll get us turned around. Put us on camera. Much to the dismay of the Wynne public. We got our lights off. Coach, would you mind putting that on? And back we are for the Cross Ridge Community Hospital postgame show. I'm here with Coach Clay Totty after the big win. Congrats on the win, Coach.
Thank you, Ryan.
So, jumping right in, this was a Magnolia team that's put up 40 points in both their previous showings. What was the big difference that allowed Wynne to pitch the shutout tonight?
Well, I mean, our kids played really great. They played hard. They played focused, played discipline. You have to play discipline assignment football. Coaches did a great job preparing them. We put in a lot of work. I'm thankful to the Lord that he blessed us for that. After you're 0-2 and you get your teeth kicked in 2 weeks in a row and you come back and you're out here at about 6 o'clock, I'm thankful that he rewarded all our hard work and our preparation.
Something that it seems pretty evident is that John Watson's back in his full form. Had a great work on the ground and in the air tonight. What does his return to kind of full capacity do for this football team?
Oh, it's huge. I mean, I didn't mention that a whole lot last week because I don't want to make excuses. But he's an asset. He makes people honor up. He's a tough runner. He's a great leader. He's good on the play action. He's a huge threat. I talked to him. I guess it was Saturday, and I said, John, for us to win the game, we're going to run you, man. And, I had some coaches tell me, hey, coach, man, I don't know. We got conference coming up. And I said, no, we need to win, And as a young man, you only get so many chances to play this game, and you can't play in fear. He certainly played fearless, and he's to be commended because, I'll be honest, we've got guys that have set out with, injuries very similar to what he's played through.
Talking about fearless, Coach, went for it on fourth down 4 times tonight, converted on all 4 of those. What was part of the scouting report that knew that was going to be an open option?
Well, to be honest, you're just playing to win the ball game. It's a feel a lot of times. I mean, we've told our kids all along that we're going to go for it on fourth down. Fourth down is another down for us. We thought we were getting a good surge there, and you tell your kids, hey, we're going to play to win, and then it's 4th and 1, and you punt when you've told them something different. I'm just a believer in that they have to value your word. You don't tell them something unless you're going to hold up to that bargain. We didn't necessarily know we'd be up 21-0 opening drive the second half when we're doing that, but I'm just a firm believer. Too many people's words are meaningless now, and I was always raised to value your words. So we talked about that all week that we were going to do it, and so I felt like that's what we needed to do.
Not just on offense, the defense was playing to win too tonight. We've commended the defense in our postgame interview last week, despite the loss. It's really great to see them put up some results. One thing, what made the defense so successful tonight at generating takeaways? Abdul Fall, Simars both came up with fumble recoveries that I wouldn't say changed the momentum of the game because we were already up, but it certainly didn't hurt either.
Well, that's a point of emphasis that we, we do what we call a turnover circuit. And there again, I always tell the coaches that if you don't get the results of what you practice, then all you're doing is going through the motions. And we had played 2 games. We hadn't done that. And, that was something that we really stressed this week. We showed them clips throughout the week, we reemphasized that again yesterday, how they were loose with the ball, you know, and we said they're going to give you opportunities, and of course you do that by great effort and pursuit, you know, and our kids were doing that, man. They were flying around, you know, the first guy was getting a wrap, and they were loose with the ball.
Well, Coach Toddy, looking forward to next week, the start of conference play. Jackets are 1-2 now. You got the Brooklyn Bearcats here at Yellow Jacket Stadium. You've got to think you've got a pretty good shot at getting back to 500. How do you look at that conference opener, and how do you set the tone for league play for the Jackets?
Well, you know, conference is a big deal. You know, your non-conference games, you always play to win. Yeah, I mean, you want to win every game. If you're not playing to win, then something's wrong with you. But at the same time, you play your non-conference to prepare yourself for the conference. And, you know, it's been hit and miss for us. We've gotten better. We've got some people banged up, you know, and that's the bad thing about it. But we've improved. And you know, I think Brooklyn's a lot better. I haven't watched Brooklyn. All my focus has been on Magnolia and on the Wynne Yellow Jackets, to be honest with you. But we'll watch them this weekend. I know that they've won some games. So, you know, we'll certainly try to get prepared for them, and you know, that will be a big game for us. Thank God to get to play at home and you know, open the conference here in front of our crowd. Appreciate our crowd sticking with us. You know, a lot of people would have abandoned ship. You know, we talked about that all week. Every Friday night you get a chance to be famous, and a lot of people wrote the Wynne Yellow Jackets off, and you know, our crowd obviously had, you know, fans were here and they were supportive, and we appreciate that so much. I think our fans know what we've gone through. I think our fans know what we've dealt with, and you know, we're getting better. And you know, proud of our. I talk about our seniors a lot, but me and John were out here talking while we're waiting. You know, we played. You know, of course, we played two tight ends. So I think we played six sophomores up front on the offensive line tonight. You know, we had Wes Fuller starting. We had Gage Rice starting. We had James Archer starting. We had Cooper Thompson. So we started four sophomores tonight, and then we also played Cole Westbrook and Anthony Smith. So those guys have improved an awful lot. You know, they got their teeth kicked in, and they continue to prove. And I appreciate the people sticking with us, because, you know, really those guys will be playing JV games, and we've thrown them to the wolves, and they've continued to improve. And that's a testament to them. You know, a lot of times a sophomore gets discouraged, and you know, they took to some tough coaching, and I've continued to improve. So I'm very proud of them that they get to see the benefits of that as well.
All right. Thanks so much, Coach. Congrats on the win, and good luck next week.
Thank you, Ryan.
So we'll be right back to interview the Fumble Club player of the game, John Watson, here on the Crossroads Community Hospital postgame show. Yellow Jackets just took down the Magnolia Panthers 35-0. You're listening to Yellow Jacket Football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network. We'll be right back.
And back we are for the Crossridge Community Hospital postgame show. I'm here with John Watson, the Fumble Club player of the game. First off, congratulations. And second of all, how does it feel to be back out there? Last week, you had just one carry against Southside. You played the whole game, but weren't able to do much on the ground. How does it feel to be back out there in full function tonight?
It feels really good because, I mean, last year I had over 1,000 yards rushing, and I really enjoy running the ball, being able to contribute and get more yards and be where we have more threats on the field at one time.
The Yellow Jackets put up 283 rushing yards tonight. What do you have to say about your offensive line?
They played a heck of a ball game. They really stepped up. You know, Coach Toddy said we had four starting. We had four sophomore linemen, and they really stepped up their game from these past couple of weeks.
And then the passing game, you really tightened things up, 3-for-3. How has this weekend practice kind of brought some focus to the passing game, and how did that take into effect tonight?
Well, I mean, after last week, I was 4-for-10 and just really had to lock in, and I got with everybody, and we just made sure that we were trying to be as precise as possible in the passing game.
John, y'all went for it on fourth down four times. What was the pressure like in those situations to try to convert for your team?
Every time there was a fourth down, I went over the huddle. I'd tell everybody, look, this is a fourth down. We have to get this. If we don't get this, we're off the field. We got to score here. And then everything clicked in everybody's head, and we converted.
John, last year you had a long, long bus drive all the way to Magnolia to the Panthers, where y'all actually fell 7-21. It's almost feel like you got a little revenge tonight.
Oh, yeah. It felt really good to beat them.
Well, I am certainly glad the Yellow Jacks were able to pull in a victory tonight. Thank you so much, John.
Thank you.
So we're going to take a short break, and we'll be back to wrap things up on the broadcast preview next week and talk about the college broadcast tomorrow. You're listening to the Crossridge Community Hospital postgame show and Yellow Jacket football on KWIN, part of the EAB Sports Network.